Hi everybody, it's Heather and I'm here today with a review of The Martian by Andy Weir. Now this book is a sci-fi thriller and it kind of follows Mark Watney, who is one of six crew members on the third manned mission to Mars. And Mark is a botanist and he's very intelligent, but he also has this wonderful personality and this great sense of humor about himself and about the things around him. And what happens is they're on their sixth day on Mars and out of a 2-month mission, and this huge Martian sandstorm blows in, and they knew it was coming, but it ended up coming in much quicker and with much more ferocity than they had thought it originally to have, and it causes them to have to evacuate. But while they were on their way to the escape pod, the communication satellite dish broke off and went flying and hit Mark, and a piece of the metal stabbed into him and it kind of knocked him off his feet, and the winds were so strong it kind of blew him away a little bit. And the other crew members tried to save him, tried to get to him, but they couldn't. And the way their suits are set up, they have access to each other's vitals and communications and stuff like that, and Mark's vitals were at zero, and so they assumed him to have died. And the commander had to make the tough decision to go ahead and evacuate the rest of the crew. And so that's what she did. The book is written in the form of Mark's log entries that he's keeping, you know, of his current situation and just of his day-to-day life on Mars and where he's, you know, what he's trying to do. And he's also wanting to leave something behind in the event that he doesn't survive. And it's just a great book. It's well written. It's brilliantly written, I should say. Andy really put, you could tell, so much effort and thought and research into this book. And there's a lot of science in this book, but it's not a dull kind of situation. I don't want that to kind of scare you off at all, because it is not like that at all. It is written not in a clinical way, and the science parts don't talk at you or down to you. It is Mark explaining his scientific method to his current, what he's trying to currently do to survive. And with Mark's personality and sense of humor, it is just very engaging and interesting. And of course, by this point, you are very attached and very invested in Mark and his survival. So when the science talk comes into play, you are interested. You want to know, how is he going to make this work? And that is just makes it so interesting. And there was a few things throughout this book that I had to stop and go and look it up, because I want my curiosity in the science method or whatever he was doing just piqued my curiosity so much that I had to go and get more information on that subject and how it really could work and in real life. And I love books that make you want to learn more about the topic, and that's what this book did. This book also has such a huge range of emotions. Again, with Mark's sense of humor, you found yourself laughing or giggling to yourself with a lot of parts, but there's also that sense of urgency and that fear, especially if you allowed yourself to really get into Mark's shoes and allowed your imagination to kind of run with it. Then you felt this anxiety and this fear for him. And there was a couple times where I had to throw the book down and I just threw my head back on the pillow, and I had tears streaming down the side of my face because I was just so upset and sad or scared for him. Or it was just very emotional book all the way around. You did get a sense of every emotion throughout this book, and it was just so interesting, and I just loved the character development and this situation that Andy had created. And it was kind of like very MacGyver in space is the way I kind of describe it, and it just kind of fits it perfectly, because that's what he had to do. He had to use an ingenuity with a lot of things, and he had to just like really think outside of the box to survive this. I give it a 5 out of 5 stars, and it is without a doubt one of my favorite reads of 2014, and I would even go as far as to say that it is one of my favorite books of all time, which says a lot for me, because a lot of the books that I consider my favorite of all time are usually in the fantasy genre. And for the fact that a sci-fi book managed to go in there and make it into that all-time list speaks volumes for this book, in my opinion, because it is just brilliant, and I highly suggest and recommend that you go out and check this book out, because I guarantee you will not regret it. If you have read this book, let me know in the comment section below what you thought about it, and if it is a book that you think that you might be interested in, let me know also in the comment section below, because I look forward to hearing from you guys, and I love talking to everybody. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this review, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!